Navigating the timeline is crucial for speedy editing in Final Cut. And there are many keyboard shortcuts that can zoom you in and out so you can see what you want to in the timeline. But I'll show you a fit-in window shortcut that you can use without moving your fingers off the mouse or the trackpad. You'll also be able to use this zoom feature to be able to edit text that's so small you can hardly see it on a web page. And at the end of the tutorial, I'll show you how to see what browser tips have been used in your timeline. If you've got topics that you'd like to have covered in a tutorial, let me know in the comments. I'm Bruce Macbryde, and I can provide training over the internet. Just click the link training.finalcutpro.com. When you're zoomed into Final Cut Timeline, there are a number of keyboard shortcuts such as Command Plus, Command Minus, Shift Plus Z, Home Key, N Key, and these will all show you different views of the timeline. But they mostly require you to use two fingers, and they all require you to move from the mouse or the trackpad to the keyboard. Did you know that there's a mouse trackpad action that will show fit-in window that works on Final Cut? Simply double press the middle of the mouse with one finger, or double press the trackpad with two fingers. The timeline view will jump to fit-in window. And incidentally, this fit-in window action also works in iMovie. To do this, you'd need to have the smart zoom ticked in the mouse and trackpad system settings. Select the Apple menu, System Preferences, type mouse or trackpad in the search field, click the icon and make sure that point and click is selected and tick the smart zoom. And that's it. And as an added bonus, this will also allow you to zoom into Safari web pages and some other apps, including Preview and Keynote. And finally, the tip to see the event browser clips that have been used in the timeline. Some of these clips are in the timeline. Which ones, you may ask? Select View in the menu bar, and under the Browser heading, select Used Media Ranges. The orange bars show the clips in the timeline, but not only just the clips, they actually show the parts of the clips that have been used, and that's brilliant. Let me know in the comments if you've got areas that you struggle with in Final Cut. I'd be happy to do a tutorial to cover those issues. In the meantime, thank you for watching. Please like, subscribe, and press the bell.